Let's learn how to create NFTs with the asset config in your transaction within a smart contract. Just like creating fungible ASAs, you use the itxn.assetconfig in your transaction to create a non-fungible ASA with different configurations. Here we have an asset config in your transaction creating a non-fungible ASA. First, you need to create the asset config object and status fields. Here, the total supply is set to 100, and the decimals parameter is set to 2. This decimals parameter specifies the number of decimal places for this ASA, indicating that the smallest unit will be 1/100th of a whole token. In this configuration, one unit of the ASA represents 1/100th of the total supply. So this is a fractional NFT divided into 100 equal parts. According to ARC3, which is the standard for NFTs on Algorand, both pure and fractional NFTs total supply has to be exactly 1. So if you want to create a fractional NFT, the total field must be a power of 10, and the decimals field must be equal to the logarithm in base 10 of the total field. The unit name field specifies the abbreviated identifier of the ASA. Here, we're setting it to ML. The asset name field specifies the name of the ASA. Here, we're setting it to Mona Lisa. The URL field specifies the link to the metadata of the NFT. This URL is usually set to some external storage like IPFS. The manager field specifies the account that has authority to change the manager, reserve, freeze, and clawback addresses after creation of the ASA. And here we're setting it to the application account. The reserve field specifies the account that will hold the total supply of the ASA upon creation. This is used if you want to control the amount of the ASA in the market. Here we're setting it to the application account as well. The freeze field specifies the account that has the authority to freeze the ASA in others' account. So by setting this field to an address, you're saying that this ASA is a freezable asset. And here we're setting it to the application account. The clawback field specifies the account that has the authority to forcefully take back the ASA from someone's account. So by setting this field, you're saying that this ASA is a clawbackable asset. Here we're setting it to the application account. One thing to note here is that the manager, reserve, freeze, and clawback fields are completely optional fields. And if you do not set them, the ASA will permanently not have a manager, a reserve account, freeze account, and a clawback account. After creating the asset config in your transaction object, you can submit the transaction by calling the .submit method.